Well, on the heels of the big night for Democratic presidential hopefuls who will take the center stage at their first debate, Congressman Mark Takai joining us in studio. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, thank you. Aloha. Yeah.
All right. Hey, okay, let's dive right on into it. This is the big night, but it's not expected to be the reality show that the other side has been going through right now. What do you expect or what do you hope to see from the Democrats?
I think, with this being the first live debate for the Democratic nominees, Democratic candidates, give people an opportunity to see what the huge policy differences are between the five candidates. I think it's important. You know, debates for the American public help shape what their positions are in terms of the candidates. And as we move forward into the presidential election, debates even take on a more important meaning.
We heard just a little while ago from Tulsi Gabbard saying that she was disinvited. Have you had a chance to speak with her?
You know, I've talked to her a couple times yesterday. In fact, she got pinned major at a punch bowl. But, you know, I didn't have a chance to talk to her about this particular issue. But I'll tell you this. I think Tulsi has a good point. For us on the Democratic side, I think it's important to have as many debates as possible. And I think that's her point, you know. We need to create more opportunities for people in the American public and for us here in Hawaii to have the opportunity to see and hear our candidates. And the fact that they've capped it, I believe, at only six is problematic. And like I said, I think Tulsi has a great point there.
Now, you and Tulsi both voted in favor of the National Defense Authorization Act recently. You know, you also played a part in some amendments. What were some of those?
Right. Well, I think the biggest amendment that we have right now that I think would be of interest to the public here is that we put some specific wording in terms of the Red Hill underground storage fuel tanks. And it calls upon the, now that the agreement has been done between the EPA, the Navy, and the state, it calls upon the Navy to come forward to Congress to brief us and provide us with information and details of how the way forward is going to look. So we're looking forward to that discussion. We had a chance to talk with the Navy yesterday, and I think they are looking forward to that discussion as well.
Yeah, speaking of talk story, mm-hmm. you have something pretty big coming up involving the SAB administrator.
Yeah, one of the very first things I did once I got named to the Small Business Committee and ranking on contracting the workforce was to invite the Small Business Administration Administrator, Maria Contreras-Sweet, to Hawaii, and she's going to be here starting from tomorrow. So Wednesday, 3:15 to 5 at the State Capitol, we've invited her to talk story. We've invited elected officials and the State Capitol, but more importantly, we're inviting small business owners, middle-sized business owners to come and hear what's in store for them as it relates to programs and services offered by the SBA.
All right, thank you so much for making us part of your trip. I know
you're
having to make that long trip from the East Coast out to Hawaii constantly.
Right,
so
right. But I
appreciate
tell people I work
away.
In D.C., but I still live in Hawaii, so I've got to come home.
That's right. Representative Mark Takai, thank you so much again.